ओके। हेलो एवरीवन, गुड इवनिंग। आई एम अनुजा आनंद ऑन बिहाफ ऑफ टीम ओआईजी। आई एम हियर टू कंडक्ट अनदर सेशन विद यू। वी हैव टुडे विद अस ब्यूटीफुल एंड अ वंडरफुल स्पीकर वीडी पूजा बालकृष्ण शेट्टी जी। शी इज एमडी इन आयुर्वेदा फ्रॉम तिलक आयुर्वेदा महाविद्यालय। शी इज एमए इन संस्कृत, नाउ असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर at Simon Ayurveda College, Mumbai. She is currently working as a consultant Ayurveda practitioner at Ayush Ayurveda and Panchkarma Clinic at Ghatkopar. She and also Madhav Priya Ayurveda Clinic and Panchkarma Center, Kandivali. And she's also presented quite a few papers at various conferences. So now I would like to welcome you, ma'am, to our platform OYG. Ma'am, my first question to you would be, how can I improve my approach towards being healthy?
Hello Anuja, thank you for the wonderful introduction. The VD stands for Vaidya, because an Ayurveda doctor has a Vaidya as her prefix, and the VD stands for the Vaidya. And yeah, can you just please repeat the question?
Sure, ma'am. How can I improve my approach towards being healthy?
Okay, improve your approach towards being healthy. If you consider a typical Ayurveda approach, what do you call health according to Ayurveda? Sam dosh, sam agni, sam dhatu, malakriya, prasanna, atma, indriya, manaha, swas iti abhideya. Now, what do you mean health? Health is a balance of all aspects, including your physical, your mental, you should be happy mentally. Also, your sensory organs, your motor functions. It does not just mean your particular weight or a particular waist size. It means an overall health. That is, when you have this approach towards your health, that everything is in perfect balance or everything is together, you may feel physically healthy, but mentally you're not. You're feeling weak, or you're not that happy, or you're feeling depressed. That itself is not a good approach to health. A health should always include a holistic approach and overall approach. That is what you should have, or everybody should have, in terms of health at least.
Ma'am, my next question would be, what is my short-term and long-term prognosis according to you or according to Ayurveda?
Okay, and what do you, just I wanted to clear that, what do you mean by prognosis? What are you looking for in prognosis?
Ma'am, prognosis as in, ma'am, what should be my medical condition right now, and like what should be coming in the future, like what all diseases I can have, or looking towards my appearance right now.
Okay. What all can you one more thing, when we are taking a patient in consideration, or when we are considering a health in consideration, your look or your appearance won't not play a completely will not give a complete picture. Your age will give me a better idea what age you are and what are the diseases you may face according to your age, what complaints you have. Because what Ayurveda says is a complete checkup, or a complete, what do we do, a complete pariksha of the whole body. Accordingly, what complaints you'll be facing in your future based on you are quite young, you may not have a lot of diseases, but as age progresses and depending upon your complaints, you may again, you're physically fit, not have proper sleep, you may have hair fall, you may have PCOD, you may have a lot of things. There are a whole list of things which goes upon. But short-term prognosis is always what we say, you check your, there are basic parameters on which we check the health, which is your appetite. You are not just not eating for the sake of eating. You're actually hungry at that time. That will give you a prognosis of your current health. Your bowel movements, sometimes regular, sometimes not regular. That itself is a bad prognosis for your health. Bad prognosis as in an indication that something is wrong somewhere. That itself gives you your health. Your sleep pattern. You are sleeping 8 hours a day, but when you get up in the morning, you do not feel fresh, or you do not feel like getting up. That itself is a short-term bad prognosis of your health. These are the parameters which we consider. Whenever you are considering health, or whenever you are looking forward or to check, or when you want to check how your health is, these parameters matter. Your menstrual cycle will matter a lot. How is it? How is it proper? Is it not proper? Is it painful? All these things will come when you consider a prognosis for your health. Similarly, you asked me long-term prognosis, I think.
Yes, ma'am. Yes. I asked both.
Yeah, the long-term prognosis will again have a huge array of parameters. Long-term prognosis depending upon your age, depending upon your health. What Ayurveda says, that there are different stages of life. Okay, Kaumaryavastha or the age when you are a kid or when you are just developing, all your tissues are developing and the body is developing, will be around 16, 17, 16, 20. When you have reached your maturation, that will be around 30, and when 30, 40. When your body starts degenerating, that will be around 40 plus. If those symptoms are seen earlier, if a 30 plus lady has joint pains and arthritis, that is a bad prognosis on the long term basis. If a 40 old person has to take cholesterol meds or has to take BP meds, that is quite a bad prognosis in the long term. So all these factors play a major role in what point of life, what complaints you are facing, and is that the complaint which you should be facing depending upon your health. So that is one thing.
Thank you, ma'am. That was great information. My next question would be, how will I know if the Ayurveda medication is working for me in the pandemic? If I take Ayurveda medication, then?
How will you know how medicines work for you? That's the same way how Ayurveda medicines will tell you. How are you feeling again? If you take the pandemic into consideration, what medication you're taking in the pandemic, if I consider only corona. If you're taking medications for corona, if Ayurveda medicines will work when your symptoms will reduce, that is the way what Ayurveda medicines will work. And one thing, how Ayurveda medicines work as different from other medicines is, it will make your body fight the disease. There is a myth that you take this kind of medicines, you'll be completely immune to some things. The question is not immunity. Immunity is how your body is responding to that disease. When you have that disease, how your body is going to respond. If your body is able to fight the disease, or is it depending upon external factors, or does it just become so weak that you have to go admitted, or you have to be on oxygen support, or you have to be on ventilator. These are the parameters which will tell you how your medicines are actually working. If your body is fighting, that is the time when how you decide the Ayurveda medicines are working, because all our medicines or all natural medicines will not work chemically or will not work synthetically and suppress the symptoms. They will make the body fight against the disease. So this is when you realize that the medicine is working or you're getting the results of it, as you do for any other kind of medicine.
Very well. Ma'am, how long will the Ayurveda medication treatment take to, you know, show the results?
Okay, this is a very common question which we have, and any patient who comes for us, they will always ask us, what is the time taken for the disease to get cured? It again depends on the disease. You cannot ask for a disease which you have, for example, a psoriasis disease. You may having a history of 15 years. You can't expect it to go within a week or two. That is not how your disease will get treated. You want to suppress your symptoms for sure. You have a range of medicines to be taken to suppress the symptoms. You take steroids, you take all kinds of medicines, symptoms separated, but you will never be free of the disease. You will keep on having the disease. But if you want to get actually treated, a 15-year disease will take some time for the pathogenicity developed in the body to be reduced. It will take around 1.5-2 months, depending upon your condition, depending upon the case. So there's a bad misconception for Ayurveda that it takes a lot of time. It doesn't take a lot of time. It needs to prepare your body to fight the disease. The same thing, a very big history of disease cannot be cured within a day or two or a week or two, and expecting miracles. You can't expect miracles with your body. You have to give it some time. So that is how medicines will work. Depending upon the disease, upon the severity of the disease, it will take the time required for the body to react. And plus, if you have followed the doctor guidelines, if you have not, it will take more. You have to follow the guidelines given to you.
Ma'am, my next question would be, what risks and benefits are associated with Ayurvedic treatments?
Risk. Okay, let me again go step by step. The risk of Ayurvedic treatments. There will be a risk if you have not taken the proper consultation. There will risk, as in all kinds of risk, adverse effects on your health, adverse effects on your overall state of the disease. But then the risk associated are not with Ayurveda medicines per se. The risks are associated how you have taken the medicine, so how you have approached it, how you have approached the treatment. If you have taken over the counter medications, if you consider WhatsApp messages and Google information pages at Ayurveda medicines, you will definitely going to have risk, because any Ayurveda doctor, a person who has studied studied even a basic graduation in Ayurveda will tell you there is no one size fits all or one shoe fits all concept in Ayurveda. That is, every disease has to be tackled differently. And if you consider this medicine, you take this and all diseases will be cured. And that is not the way. That will cause its side effects. That will have its side effects. So that is an approach we should be not be taking. That those will have your risk. And the benefits is, again, you are making your body fight the disease. You're making your body stronger. Whenever this you are trying to break the cycle of the disease, not depending on always an external factor to treat your disease. That is one plus point you can always have, because we are aiming at balancing all the imbalances which has been formed. Whatever a disease has brought imbalance in you, we are working towards creating a balance so that in future, if it comes or in future, if it triggers, your body itself will fight it. You do not have to give, or we don't have to always be dependent on medicines and always be having that ek BP ka goli or ek diabetes ka goli always throughout your life. So that will help you in understanding.
Ma'am, my next question would be, what are the Ayurvedic treatment options to reach optimum health?
Okay, the Ayurvedic treatment options are many. They are again based on what kind of disease you are facing, what kind of disease you have. But there are basics, the basic treatment modalities is we have shamana medicines. Shamana medicines is what? They reduce the disease. Whatever complaints you have, they will reduce the symptoms. They will treat the symptoms. They will treat the imbalances. Not the symptoms, it will be the imbalances, as in for what is the cause. Every disease will have its cause. It will generate from somewhere. It will negate the cause and it will treat that. It will start treating from there. That is a shamana medicine. We have oral medications. We have all sorts of internal applications or external applications. Those things will play a role. Second is panchkarma medicine. Now this panchkarma has become the big highlight for detoxification. So it is not a detoxification procedure. It is not definitely a spa procedure. You have people have made a panchkarma as a spa procedure. It is definitely not that. What it does, if a disease has a long chronic history, or it has been, like I said, a 15-year history or a 20-year history, there has been a buildup of toxins in your body because of the disease going through your body for 15 years or 20 years. So what does Shodhana medicine? So these come under Shodhana medicine. What they do, they remove those toxins from their body. Once and for what the pileup has been there, they remove it, and then we give oral medication, and then we give shamana medicine, so that you treat it, you have cleaned the body, or you have removed the deposits which were left, and then you're treating the medicine so that there's a complete balance maintained in the body. And the third part of any Ayurveda medication or any Ayurveda treatment has always been a change in your lifestyle, a change in your diet. A diet plays a very important role in Ayurveda medicine, because Ayurveda always says, does not give as much importance to medicines as it gives importance to diet. If a bad diet is the main cause of disease, that is the sutra of Ayurveda. A bad diet, a bad digestive process is the main cause of disease. So no Ayurveda treatment will be done without a diet and life. And diet does not mean all restrictions. That is also a misconception. Ki Ayurveda treatment gives a lot of restrictions. You don't get to eat anything. You only have to have a sattvic diet. That is not what Ayurveda diet is. It tells you what is good for you and what is bad for you. And the things which are bad for you, you have to know. Half of the people we come across, the patients come across, they don't even know how the disease has originated and what is causing this triggering factor every time they go out, every time they have something. They say, achanak aa gaya, that's idiopathic. I am prone to it. There's nothing like you're prone to it. There has been some buildup in your body which is causing it. So you have to know what is that thing which is causing it. So you have to remove it from the diet. And that thing which has caused you enough pain for 15 years, if you are asked to remove it, I don't think it's asking too much to remove. So that is how an Ayurveda treatment works. A Shodhana, Shamana, and a proper diet and lifestyle consultation.
Okay, ma'am. How patients can take an active role in their care and safety in pandemic through Ayurveda?
Okay. Active role, a patient, if you have to take care and play an active role in your health, is being more aware of your health. Please do not run behind the pills or the immunity pills, because you cannot get them you cannot get your body immunity from a pharmacy or from a clinic. It will always depend on how you have maintained your health through the course of many years. Ayurveda says the main immunity starts when a mother starts conception. When the baby is formed, when the conception, and that's where the immunity builds up. So how you have maintained your immunity, from there it will come, or from there it will develop. What a person can do if you want to play an active role is be aware of your body's requirements, be aware of its needs. Eat when you are hungry, sleep when you are sleepy. Don't have ghante mein khana ka period, or 1 hour meals, or 2 hour meals when you do not require it. Be more aware of your body's requirements. What your body's requirements are may be completely different from your neighbor's body's requirements. So as a person who is aware of your disease or aware of your body, you are much more, you can take much more active role to know what is good for you and what is bad for you. This is how you can play a major role in being more active in your health-wise.
Thank you, ma'am. And why do women choose Ayurveda as their first choice of treatment?
Hello, am I visible?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, sorry, can you please come again?
Yes, ma'am. Ma'am, why do women choose Ayurveda as their first choice of treatment?
Okay, this is my favorite topic, because I like to work in human health in this field. Why should women choose? The major role why women should choose is a woman's body is much different from a man's body. You have to realize the difference. Our requirements are different, our needs are different, our cycles are completely different. What works for others will not work for us, because we are more in tune with nature. Because our hormonal cycle, our menstrual cycle, they are more in tune with nature. And Ayurveda is a science which deals with the balance of nature, or with deals which is more closer to nature. That is what one thing why women should always, because what we see or what we see around is any imbalance, you pop up in. You have menstrual cramps, you pop up in. You have and they are told you have to live with these pains. This pain is a part and parcel of being a woman, a part and parcel of having periods. Since you are having periods, you will have pain. So this concept needs to be removed. That this has been, I don't think allopathy also proclaims it, or any other science proclaims it, but that is what the general mentality has become. You have to have those pains, and you have to have those cramps, and even gynecologically, if you're having some problems, if you're having miscarriages, it is an unknown cause. You are prone to miscarriages, or you are prone to fibroids. There's nothing like prone to. There has to be some cause. And these causes are better understood in Ayurveda, or Ayurveda gives you definite causes. It tells you you have to avoid these kind of food, you have to avoid these kind of lifestyle, or you have to take such precautions. We have various aspects. We have typical regimens to be followed after your periods or during your periods. Typical regimens, we call it paricharya. A typical regimen to be followed in when you have just delivered, or when you have just having a baby, or in what period of time which you have to follow the regimen, or when you are going to be menopausal. There always has been a regimen, and no other science explains it in much detail as Ayurveda. It has given a very in-depth, detailed view of all these things. That's why Ayurveda is much more helpful to women, or women respond very well to Ayurvedic treatments, because again, there is no quick fixes. It actually tells you the cause and actually treats your cause. So that is why women should prefer, in order to, if they have to break that cycle of pain, and if they have to break that mentality, the suffering, it always comes with menstruation or delivery or C-section. You have to break that mentality. For that, you need an Ayurvedic approach to it.
Okay. Ma'am, what are the most common herbs which are required for them to keep healthy, for women to keep healthy?
Okay, the most common herbs, there are a list of common herbs. And basically, I have much more aversion to these herbs taken by women, because there are turmeric, there is shatavari, there is ashoka, there is aloe vera. But everything will not work for you. And people do take, and it's very sad to hear taking aloe vera juice per day or daily, or taking turmeric decoction daily. They are herbs which are used as medicines, but they have a specific need, they have a specific dose, and they have a specific requirement. Everybody cannot take. You have patients coming with piles and severe IBS syndromes because they have been taking such kind of medicines daily. And as an Ayurveda doctor, I'm strictly against giving these herbs, because what is the mentality? Since it is Ayurveda, since it's herbal, is going to be safe, and we should take these herbs in our daily diet, or you should take these herbs in our regular intake. That is completely not the case. These herbs have been, none of these herbs have been mentioned in the daily diet. Whatever you see, the ginger part, the turmeric part has only been mentioned in your food intake, how much you are using. It has never been mentioned to take it a daily of teaspoon or half teaspoon. That has never been mentioned. If it has been mentioned, it has been mentioned in specific conditions only. So unless and until you know your condition, or unless and until that typical herb is prescribed to you or given to you, you should not be taking it. Otherwise, there is a list of herbs, but to give it or to just say it, and people taking a wrong notion out of it, or people not taking it properly, that itself causes many diseases. And then Ayurveda, the blame comes on Ayurveda, since we have been taking it, and since we are having these, and then we are having this deposition, then we are having these medicines, then we had kidney problems and this problem, that they have been generated by not taking it properly. What has been given, the texts have not lied. The texts have told you very properly how to take it. You have interpreted it wrongly. So the list of herbs, even if they are there, they should always be taken with proper consultation and with proper knowledge of those herbs. That will be always better.
Thank you, ma'am. Ma'am, how Ayurveda physicians help women in the prevention of multiple aspects?
Ayurveda, can I please repeat the question?
Ma'am, how Ayurveda physicians help women in the prevention of multiple aspects that a female goes through?
Okay, the multiple aspects which a female go through, first we have to realize what are these multiple aspects are. As you say, the multiple aspects starts from the age, for a woman specifically, the major age disease problem starts from her menarche itself. Okay, at that time, if she has not done it, if the menarche is not proper, it is irregular, her menstruation is not proper, it is irregular, it will start from there, a bad lifestyle will start from there, PCOD will start from there. Then every stages, when in pregnancy, you do not follow the proper regimens taken. We are too busy in our lifestyle. We do not have time to take proper care of your body. There has been given specific steps in Ayurveda. There has been Siddhika Paricharya in Ayurveda to be followed. What to be done and for how long to be done. No, we do not follow it. We are in too much of rush to get back to our original work life. Very well not knowing this will cause problems in later life. What we see in the menopausal problems, which we see later, will always start if you're not done. The care has not been taken when you are pregnant, or when you are going through the processes, or even when you have miscarried or had abortions. Even these require specific regimens to be followed, which Ayurveda helps in telling you. Even in the 9 months of pregnancy, we have a detailed list of the things to be done. There are certain foods you should be eating. Every month has a specific diet to be followed, specific medications to be taken, all as far as garbha sanskar every month. That will help her to have an easier delivery, a normal delivery. A normal delivery is always preferred in Ayurveda, because that helps to the body to regain to its original posture. So in these aspects, Ayurveda can help with every stage from her menarche to her menopause, the various diseases which a woman faces, the fibroids which she faces. Always hysterectomy is not the answer. Hysterectomy is... Ayurveda is not against surgery. It will tell you surgery if there is need for it, but not always. If there is a second opinion, because hysterectomy is not the answer to all your menstrual problems post 40. You have finished your, you have done with your reproductive age, so you can completely remove that organ, or you have no use of that organ. That mentality has itself to stop, because that itself will cause problems. Every organ has its role. They have a role in calcium deposition. They have a role in your overall health. If that is completely removed without proper knowing the side effects which comes from it, or the knowing the consequences of it, so that Ayurveda helps you out. What are the consequences of it? If hysterectomy is the only option, are there other options available to you? Can you make changes in your regular routine which will help you with those problems? There are specific yoga and pranayama exercises which are given to women specifically. Surya Namaskar has been highly helpful in women for all her hormonal symptoms and all her hormonal problems. So there it can help you. So this is what Ayurveda does, and Ayurveda physician does. Understands the age, understands the requirement of that age, the specific problems of that age, and will give you regimens to be followed. It even gives you daily regimens should be followed. We have dinacharya, we have rutucharya, we have season-wise changes, we have day-wise changes. So this is what Ayurveda helps you with. It helps you understand your body's requirements, helps you understand your body's needs, and accordingly, it will help you to solve your problems. This is what we do.
Ma'am, my next question would be, why and how PCOD is becoming very common in this generation? And is there anything that we can that can be done through Ayurveda to reverse it or to not, you know, happen it, prevent it?
PCOD, why that has been common? That is a question which has been made into thesis now. Because if you go to see, everyone among three has now PCOD. PCOD is polycystic ovarian disease. You do not, you have not maintained a proper hormonal cycle. There are cysts form on your ovaries. And how much ever you deny it, it is a lifestyle disease. It has been developed from a lifestyle problem. We consider everything taken in regard, and this has always come, also come from the food you have taken, from when you are bleeding. What is always said actually, we have been told since generations to have a proper meal, or when you are having periods, you should go for easier meals, or you should take rest. But that concept has completely changed. We are being feminist about it. We should not take. We will do everything, even when we are in bleeding, or even when we are menstruating. We want to be the super girls or super women. Okay, we can do everything. You are super women. We can do everything. But there are some days which should not be done. Some days when your body requires that rest. When you are admitted in a hospital, you have bleeded out. You do not run and jump and dance about. You take rest. So that is what we, those things have not been followed. We are being too busy in our life that we do not listen to our body's requirements. Specifically during menstruation, spicy foods are to be avoided. You have to avoid certain foods, but Abhishandi foods like yogurt. Yogurt has become a major part of diet of many girls, many ladies. They call it probiotics, they call it nutrients, and they have it daily just because gut bacteria, it improves. They have no idea what gut bacteria is till they have one cup of yogurt daily. So these practices, specifically when you are menstruating, have all added on to these problems, because a cyst form is according to us a kapha vyadhi. If at that time, if you take more of those things, if you take more of those diet, and you are having outside, you're having junk. You're having junk other days, but specifically when you're having on those days, it will have its repercussions. So that is why, because of all these practices which we have been following, there has been imbalances in the body which has led to PCOD. Now, coming back to what Ayurveda can do in PCOD, it will tell you what your body needs again. It will tell you what you should be doing, what you should not be doing. There are medications for PCOD. There are good managements for PCOD. We give internal medications for, we also give Uttarvasti if needed be in some conditions in some ladies, because PCOD has always also given rise to infertility conditions. So there we can treat the patient accordingly. Then we can again give a proper a diet and lifestyle which should be maintained. There are specific exercises should be done. There are specific asanas should be done. Basically, PCOD is also a major factor because of stress conditions. And because of PCOD, you have weight gain and you have low sense for confidence seen among girls, very young girls, because of the weight gain and the hirsutism, which the facial hair, which it accompanies with. So there we can help you out. We can let you know what you should be doing, what you should not be doing. And main thing what Ayurveda will tell you is help to break the cycle. You help to have a normal cycle of your periods without inducing or without having any chemicals or any synthetic subsidiaries or stimulants to have your periods, because those will be temporary. You cannot always have it. Only when you're a medic, there are patients coming to us, only on those medications they are bleeding. Or the patients coming to us who did not have periods for 7 to 8 months and they have no idea what they are doing wrong. And they have this, they are exercising for 2 months and they're getting back to normal. But they have no idea that something is going on in their body. So this is where Ayurveda can help you out. It helps you to tell you what you need and what you don't need, so that all other balances will be maintained.
Thank you, ma'am. And my last question would be that Ayush treatment can help in prevention of lifestyle disorders, except for PCOD as well?
all lifestyle disorders have been Ayush treatment. I'm sure all other parties, Ayush includes other parties also, includes homeopathy, includes Siddha. I'm sure all those parties would say the same. What I can speak about is Ayurveda. Yes, Ayurveda will help you a lot in lifestyle diseases because it will tell you you're doing what lifestyles you're doing wrong, basically. It will tell you that. And it will, and there are medications, there are no medications, complete treatments in any other party for your other diseases such as diabetes, for blood pressure. You are always medicine dependent. You are always dependent on your reports. So these diseases, Ayurveda does play a major role. There are treatments, depending upon the cases. Again, I cannot make a blanket statement. All will get treated or everything will get treated, but you'll have a very good result. Your body will able to maintain the levels very well on their own, and you will not have to be always dependent on any synthetic medicines for it, basically. And if you change your overall lifestyle and health, and you know what your requirements are, you know what amount of water you should be drinking, you know what amount of food you should be eating, or how you should be eating. Many a times we eat right, but we do not know how you are eating. Our practices are wrong. We eat the best amount of the costliest food or the most exotic foods, the most high-end foods. But the way we are eating it, the time we are eating it, any amount of nutritious food or the proteins, carbs and fats you have measured, if you're eating at 10 o'clock at night, is not going to be of any use. It is going to cause you diseases such as diabetes and blood pressure. It is going to give you all sorts of problems. So these things you need to understand how you should be doing it. In this way, Ayurveda helps a lot.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you for a very lovely, knowledgeable, exciting segment today. We hope and we would love to see you again. Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you so much, ma'am. It was a very great experience is what we have. The questions were not related to your field, maybe in terms of your degree we talk about. But as an individual, if I am a common person or if I am a student, I should see from the top to bottom, from covering perspective of every question. So we have planned in such a way. Maybe next time we will have the particular what you have done regards to that, because Anuja was concerned that we should ask only that question. I was like, it was great that in second session we would come to that part what we were looking forward. So thank you so much, ma'am, because it was a very great for me, for our team and for the students who are going to watch this. That's a very great opportunity what you have given us.
Thank you, ma'am.
So
thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.